While a lot has been written about the 1947 partition of the country, there are very few who documented the plight of women during the traumatic event. There was, however, one writer who captured the collective memory of the partition of Bengal as well as the implications and the aftermath. In this video, we take a look at the life and work of pioneering writer Jyotirmoyee Devi, who documented women during the 1947 partition. Jyotirmoyee Devi was born in 1894 in Jaipur in an upper caste and economically well-off family. Jyotirmoyee's place of birth had a profound impact on her writings. Considering the time she was living in, she did not get the opportunity to get formal education. Her sole means to establish a relationship with reading became her grandfather's library, where she, along with her sister, were assigned to arrange newly arrived books and magazines. This was a privilege she grabbed with both hands. Her daughter Ashoka Gupta mentions in an interview that even though being married to a lawyer at the minor age of 10, Jyotirmoyee was given a free will to pursue reading and writing, unlike many of her contemporaries. Jyotirmoyee had 6 children, and this was followed by her husband's demise due to influenza. As was the societal norm at the time, she was sent back to her parents' house and was expected to dissociate herself from any kind of social life. While being confined by orthodox tradition and being secluded, reading became Jyotirmoyee's outlet to the outside world, while writing offered her a new life of comfort and solitude. Her writing helped her claim her space in society. After spending a long while in Rajasthan, Jyotirmoyee moved to Bengal. In 1922, one of her poems was published in the leading Bengal magazine, Bharatvarsh, for the very first time. Another pioneering writer, Mahashweta Devi, defines Jyotirmoyee as an extremely alert and conscious writer whose writing was mainly cerebral. Jyotirmoyee Devi's writing was aware of the sociological aspects of the time and settings, focusing on the living conditions of women and the social expectations that haunted their lives in several ways. Having lived in both Rajasthan and Bengal, her writing saw an amalgamation of cultures. In her writing, she continuously questioned the status of women's rights. Her work reflects the memory of the partition in terms of women's experience as well as the exclusionary social life that ensued thereafter, thus questioning the very expectations of the ideas of independence and patriarchal nationalism and the price that the marginalized identities were forced to pay for it. Her work stressed on the fact that stories of nation formation and borders at the behest of a partition could not be recorded without mentioning the sufferings that befell hundreds of women as a result of a patriarchal outlook towards their bodies. A significant chunk of Jyotirmoyee Devi's writings also included stories that centered around the restricted lives of young girls and women in Rajasthan, having spent her early years there. One of her short stories, Beti Kabab, calls for attention to the evil of female infanticide and the limited social interaction that women were allowed. While her short story, Shei Cheleta, is a commentary on the body of a woman being allegorized and perceived as a site of familial honor, and hence, any kind of violence inflicted upon them led to their abandonment. Her famous partition novel, The River Churning, depicted the lives of the women in Bengal who bore the burden of this communal divide, whose body became sites of violence. The novel also makes effort to challenge the erasure of the tragedies endured by women across communal and religious identities. Jyotirmoyee Devi's collection of short stories, Shona Ruponoi, won the Rabindra Puraskar in 1973. She also served as the Vice Chancellor of the All India Women's Conference for a short while. She passed away in 1988. Jyotirmoyee Devi helped locate the experiences of women in the larger national struggle for independence. Her contribution to the literature on women in the country cannot be forgotten.